No doubt about it. The Kansas City Chiefs are ready for a march toward an AFC West championship, at least for the preseason. 2012 campaign began last night with a preseason debut that was exactly what the Chiefs fans wanted to see, a strong performance from the starters, leading to the team's fourth preseason victory in the last five seasons. Heading into last night's game, Kansas City was 3-17 in preseason games since 2007. They haven't exactly made a sport out of early success. Not that it matters on the record, but the 27-17 win saw the offensive starters score two consecutive touchdowns and the defensive starters hold the Cardinals scoreless. Now the focus shifts to winning on the road in St. Louis, because winning, even when it doesn't count, is still the name of the game.
Well, you always start with a clean slate because everybody is 0-0, you know, in the win-loss column when the regular season starts. But I think it depends on the maturity of your team. And where they are. You know, Indianapolis, they would lose just about all the preseason games and then kill everybody in the regular season, you know. But if you have a young team, I think being able to win some games helps their attitude, helps their preparation, and then I think it can bode well, you know, going into the regular season.
Kansas and Kansas State basketball both took the floor today with the Jayhawks starting play in Paris, while the Wildcats debuted in Brazil, losing their first test to the Brazilian Nationals 81-67. The Jayhawks, meanwhile, their first game against the French professionals in Paris. It was the third game of KU's trip to Europe, which resulted in a one-point loss. 74-73 final puts an end to the Jayhawks' run of 41 consecutive exhibition wins. It's Bill Self's first exhibition loss on foreign soil, and afterwards, self-critical of his new group in his own honest way.
Oh, we're not very good at all. We could improve on everything. I would just like to be able to pass and dribble and catch. That would be a good starting point. Forget about shooting or guarding or anything. You know, we turned it so many empty possessions and turned it over. And it, you know, we were all collectively involved with it. But probably most disappointed in the play of our returning guys, even though the newcomers had a tough night, but our returning guys didn't play very well and certainly didn't do the things that you have to do to have a chance to win on the road, especially.
Jayhawk football opened up their practice today to show off what Charlie Weiss said has been significant progress since camp first began. Weiss did showcase some changes to the depth chart, particularly on the offensive line today. Just 3 weeks prior to their season opener with South Dakota State, the Jayhawks stayed after practice for about 45 minutes, chatting it up with fans who came out to Memorial Stadium. The Ralph Wolf Riverside Tennis Center hosting its fourth annual All-Woody Doubles Tournament. This tournament is different because the participants can only use wooden rackets instead of their traditional aluminum. The wooden rackets make the game of tennis a little more difficult, which always keeps competitors in the All-Woody coming back year after year.
4 years ago, we had this great idea. We're like, hey, you know, we had this one guy that would play here with a wooden racket, and he was a good college player. And we asked him, why did he switch to the woody? And he goes, well, basically, guys, I got a little burned out in college, and I started playing again with the wooden racket for fun. I'm like, well, how about a great idea would be to play a wooden racket tournament? We're like, yeah, we should do it. So the first year, we ended up having 20 players. And that was 4 years ago. Now we've got 60 out here.
Round three of the PGA Championship at the Kiawah Island Resort in South Carolina was suspended due to severe weather. Rory McIlroy and Vijay Singh are tied for the lead at 6-under. Tiger Woods fell currently 3-over for the day. He drops to tied for 11th. And KU grad Gary Woodland is tied for 47th at 3-over for the day and 5-over for the tournament. That's all for your sports. Have a great evening.